Alright, so what to do with the L3 cache? Well, caches you should use for data that gets reused many times. If we go back to where we were here, before we erased things, what we had was a loop over row panels of C being updated by computing a block of A, or blocks of A, times the row panel of B. What you notice is that this same row panel of B gets reused for multiplications with many blocks of A to update many row panels of C. Data that gets reused should be placed in caches. But this row panel is pretty big, so we need to place it in a pretty big cache. And what that tells us is that if we have a level 3 cache, we probably should use it for this row panel of B. All right, so this really is where the data exists and where we partition it into little slivers that are our micro panels of B. Now there's a problem with that. This row panel of B may not fit in the L3 cache if B is very large, if B has many columns. So, to ensure that this row panel of B doesn't have too many columns, what we need is one more loop. Okay? We need to partition our matrix C and our matrix B in such a way that we do matrix-matrix multiplies with matrices that have a limited number of columns. How many loops do we end up with then? Well, around the microkernel, we already had 4 loops, and we're now saying we need one more loop. 5 loops around the microkernel. And that is the basic approach that modern implementations of matrix-matrix multiply employ.